Hey, Miss Johnson's fourth and fifth grade class. Hi, Gigi. My name's John. I'm a paramedic at Coast Life Support District in Gualala, California, on the southern end of the Mendocino Coast. We're standing out here in front of our station. I'm a paramedic on the ambulance, and those are the ambulances that we respond to calls in. We're gonna walk over there and we're gonna take a look at what's inside some of the ambulances. So if you look up there, that's where we sleep, up in the top two rooms. We work a 48-hour shift, meaning we work for 2 days on, and we work for we're off for 4 days. This is one of our ambulances. Open the door, you can see in here. These are all of our controls for our lights and our siren. If you look that way, you can see through to the back of what's called the patient compartment. This is called a stair chair. It helps us get patients up and down stairs. So this is the back of the ambulance. Turn some lights on here. Right here, this is the gurney. This is where the patients ride. Right there, that's all of our medical bags. These are splints for people with broken legs. This is a special bag for the kids. It's called a pediatric bag. That's a bag that has our oxygen tank in it. Up on the walls up here are all the different supplies that we'll use when we're running 911 calls. And we have medications. We have things for starting IVs on patients. We have things for helping patients breathe. All different kinds of stuff over here. Down here on the bench and on the net, we have more supplies. All stuff that we need when we're on these calls. Let's jump out the other side and we'll take a look at the bags that we take into the houses. This right here is our heart monitor. We take this inside and it can check vital signs on a patient. We can look at their heart rate. We can do what's called a 12 lead EKG. We can do a blood pressure. And it's also a defibrillator if we need to shock somebody because their heart has stopped. This bag right here is our gear bag that we take in when we go in the house. And it's got medications in there, IV bags in case we have to start IVs, lots of supplies for IVs, more medications down in here. And if we spin it around and open this side, we have more supplies to help people breathe. This is something that we use to look in somebody's airway to help put a tube in there to help them breathe. And this is called an IO machine or IO drill. And when we can't get an IV on somebody, we can actually drill a needle into their leg. We can give medications that way. All right. In here we have our big oxygen tank. And it's because sometimes we have to travel quite a ways before we get to a patient, or we have to travel quite a ways to get to the hospital.